Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. Doing this webcast is part of our commitment to our clients to help you keep informed, to understand what's happening in the marketplace, and ultimately to hear perspectives from your company. Today, I have the pleasure of being with Brent Schutte, our Chief Investment Strategist from the Northwestern Mutual Wealth Management Company, and Kamilah Williams-Kemp, our Head of Risk Products. Over the next 15 or 20 minutes, we'll share some of the big trends we're seeing and what we think that means for all of you, the clients of Northwestern Mutual. So with that, let's get started. Brent, I'm going to start with you. We've been bullish on the economy since before the pandemic. We were right about that, and it's paid off for us in many ways. But now we're through the pandemic. The recovery is strong. What are your thoughts on the next, what's going to happen in the economy in the next 6 to 12 months?
Yes, we have been pretty optimistic and throughout the entire pandemic for the most part. And quite frankly, even during the pandemic, we were much more optimistic than our industry peers, and that felt pretty lonely at first, but it has, as you mentioned, proven to be pretty prescient. And so if you think about it, last year was setting up to be a pretty good year from the economy perspective and from a market perspective, and then we were hit by COVID. And so if you think about a COVID-induced recession, we had to go back to the drawing board by February and think about how we were going to navigate our clients through a pandemic-influenced economy and market. And so we came up with some milestone markers that we thought would help guide us. And so I want to review those just for a second because I think it places it in context of where we're at now and what we expect in the future. And so our first one, which was really, really important, was that we thought monetary policy would be very aggressive and would be accompanied by very aggressive fiscal policy. And that happened really quickly, like in the first couple of weeks of the pandemic. Number two, we thought that the U.S. economy would be able to reopen even with COVID still bouncing around the globe. And so if you think about it, in early March, we were all introduced to something we knew little about. And this is where I think we were much more optimistic than our peers. We thought that as companies would figure out how to open or how they would adapt, they could figure out how to reopen and serve their clients even during COVID. And so if you think about it, we started seeing an economic improvement right after that initial shock. And that is what's most important to a market. Are you getting better or are you getting worse? Number three, we were hopeful and actually optimistic that science would find a win. And so if you think about it, find a treatment, find a vaccination. And that's kind of where we're at right now. We've had some decent results with vaccinations, the economy's reopening, and we still have a lot of economic momentum. If you think about it, people are starting to come back out in public, they're starting to spend. You are seeing that show up on both manufacturing and service companies. If you look right now, they have a ton of new orders coming in, they have a huge backlog of orders, and they have low inventories, which if you put those together, that's a recipe for future growth. The consumer, that stimulus I mentioned, actually saved quite a bit of that. So there's $2 trillion worth of aggregate savings more today than there were pre-COVID, which we think will be spent over the coming few quarters. And finally, this is now becoming more of a global recovery. And so the U.S. reopened, and now you're seeing places like the Eurozone reopen, and we think that will reinforce the U.S. recovery and, quite frankly, lead to higher markets in the future.
So we've been saying for years that we think rates are going to stay low for a long period of time. We're running the company that way. Virtually every central bank around the world is in some form of quantitative easing, more monetary stimulus than I've ever seen. But valuations are high. What do you think? What should clients be thinking about? What should our clients at Northwestern Mutual Wealth Management Company be worried about, and what should they be doing?
Yeah, you know, I think that central banks are not going to stop right now. They're going to try to peg the interest rate and the yield curve low, and they're going to stay there for some time. And you mentioned it's not just the U.S., it's globally. And so perhaps as some of these central banks eventually start tightening, you will see rates rise, but it should be a pretty delayed response. And on valuations, I mean, this is where I think people get valuations wrong. To me, valuations are a relative tool, not an absolute tool. And what causes markets to fall is recessions, not valuations. And so to me, you know, there are certainly still pockets of the market that are cheaper, and I would focus your portfolios towards that. But also remember that no one knows for certain, and diversification among not only just our investments, but also all the different products that we offer, I think is a very prudent thing to think about as you look forward.
Yeah, I totally agree. All right, Kamilah, let's get to the risk side. You know, we've seen examples over the last year. I'm sure many of our clients have experienced challenges where they've got all those what ifs. What if I get sick? What if something bad happens to somebody in my family? How do I cope with that? We found that 84% of Americans during the pandemic felt the economic downturn would have some impact on their life and on their long-term financial goals. So how can you deal with that unexpected? Can you share some thoughts with us on what clients should be doing to deal with those what-ifs in their lives?
Yes, absolutely, John. So some of the national research that we've seen and that you referenced there is that over the past year, people's sense of insecurity because of the pandemic is just all-time high. But the way that I've been thinking about it is, pandemic or not, life always has some unexpected twists and turns. And so to be proactive in the planning is what really is going to create a financial sense of peace of mind for people, no matter whether we're in a pandemic environment or not. And what's really interesting about this is, as you look at the industry, that people talk about planning all of the time, but there are very few firms that are actually delivering on it. And some of the surveys that we've conducted in that analysis, it's that less than 30% of advisors nationally are actually delivering holistic financial security planning. And at Northwestern Mutual, we certainly believe that it's a combination of insurance and investments that really drive to higher financial outcomes. And so as people are thinking about how to best tackle life's unexpected twists and turns and how to approach their advisor and having those conversations, so much of it is really thinking not only about protecting against the downside risk, but it's also dreaming big about what's possible and not being fearful that you won't be able to execute that within the plan.
We've always talked about protect and invest at the same time, and it sounds like a trite phrase, but I think the pandemic really demonstrated to many clients the efficacy of doing both at the same time. But when you sort of turn that around, the pandemic, I think, also made people realize what they didn't plan for, what they hadn't done. And so now there's this demand for planning, multi-generational planning. It's a personal thing. Planning is obviously tied to everybody's unique circumstances. What should people think about when they're planning? What should they keep in mind, particularly as it relates to generational issues from a planning perspective?
Yeah, I wish I could say I didn't have personal examples of the need,
yes,
but
I know that I do.
Yeah. And most recently, it was back in 2017, I was expecting my second child, leading a team through a really significant transition here at work, and my mom had emergency brain surgery, which resulted in pretty significant memory issues. So I found myself in this situation of juggling all of these personal and professional demands. Now, having worked with an advisor up front, I felt confident going into that situation that everything would be okay. But it's very challenging when you're in the throes of dealing with that to really make sure that you have giving yourself some grace in working through that. So my advice to people is to really think about having conversations with an advisor and with your family before the stakes are so high, right? Because when you're in the throes of those really challenging situations, that is not the time to start talking about all your deepest financial wishes and hopes and dreams, right? So talking upfront about it before the stakes are high, and as I previously mentioned, giving yourself some grace, because it is not easy to navigate through the complexities of a situation like that. And you have to have the peace of mind, having worked with an advisor, that everything will actually flow in the way that you expected for your financial security.
But talk a little bit more personally. So I doubt that you planned, correct me if I'm wrong, for your mom to have brain surgery, but you did something from a planning perspective that sort of set you up for that. If it happened, you'd be okay. So what were you thinking about when you were going through that process?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a really great probing question, because when I was setting forth the plan with our advisor and thinking about this combination of investments and insurance, I wasn't necessarily focused as much on the flexibility that the cash value of life insurance could provide. Right. But here it is now, when we're in the midst of dealing with that situation. And so having the foresight to put those things in place up front is what actually led then to that sense of the peace of mind while it was going on in the moment.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I appreciate both your perspectives today. It's awesome. I hope you can get a sense, those of you in the audience, how at Northwestern Mutual, we don't just talk about this stuff, but we're actually living it ourselves. And I think that's really cool. As we wrap up, I'd like to ask each of you a closing thought. Brent, I think as an ex-investment guy, I think the number one question I'm always going to be thinking about is, what did we learn in 2020 that we should remember going forward?
Yeah, it's hard to believe. And I think back, and I've been doing this for 27 years now, and last year was something like I'd never seen before. But the really interesting thing is, you didn't invest differently. Right. right? I actually titled my, and for people who have read my stuff, I actually titled my end of the year paper, Once in a Lifetime, Same as It Ever Was. You familiar with Talking Heads?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, as I think about that, I mean, that's the most important thing. And, you know, to me, when people ask what I do, I say I help and I play a role in providing people with financial security. And if you think about it, most people think that means all about the growth side of the equation. They think that it's when times are good, how much did you make? And to me, this reinforced last year that that's not how you attain and retain financial security. It's how you behave when times are bad. Can you stick with the plan? Anyone can save, anyone can invest, anyone can stick with an advisor's plan when times are good. Can you do that when times are bad? And that's what really, I think, drives home about how people attain and retain financial security. And if you think about this company, you just mentioned it. I mean, we don't just plan for when times are good. We also plan for life's unexpected twists and turns, which I think is really important. That can include things like a market crash or the things that you went through. And I think that's really what we do as a company and what we stand for. And if you think about it, our advisors play a central role in that. They're the ones who help guide their clients through this pandemic. And hopefully now those clients are on the opposite side of that and we can kind of go back to whatever was normal before that. But, you know, to me, financial security is not just about investments. It's about the combination of those with things like permanent life insurance for growth and for income. It's about investments and it's about annuities for guaranteed income as you age in your life.
Yeah, that's awesome. I think it was George Foreman, a heavyweight boxer, said, everyone has a plan until you get punched in the nose. And I'm really proud of the way our company, when we did get punched in the nose, got through it and really excelled in so many ways. So, Kamilah, with your closing thoughts, what final advice would you give our clients as they sign off from this webcast today and think about the future?
Absolutely. And I think, Brent, you captured it very well in terms of really thinking proactively about how to leverage the financial tools that are in our arsenal to help prepare you for life's inevitable twists and turns, the downside, but then also how to maximize what happens on those up years as well. I think the critical piece of advice that I would share is how important it is to think about your plan as a living, breathing part of your dialogue with an advisor. We all know, again, things can happen in life, and what you set out to plan to do 10 years ago may not be the same thing that you're focused on now, and that's perfectly okay. I think taking the initiative to actually refresh those conversations based on changing life circumstances is the best piece of advice that I can provide to people.
That's awesome. Well, in closing, I want to thank you, Brent and Kamilah, for your insights and wisdom. I got a lot out of it, and I'm sure our clients did too. As we wrap up, I wanted to share with you a few closing thoughts. When I think about everything going on in the world today and Northwestern Mutual, I think three things stand out to me. First is financial planning. You've heard that today. It's more important than it's ever been. Having a plan and keeping your plan up to date, staying in contact with your advisor, understanding how everything is going in the world and how it affects you, that's never been more important than it is today. Secondly, people understand that to have a financial plan, it has to be comprehensive. It has to be a plan that includes both insurance and investments. When people do only one or the other, they're left in a very, very vulnerable spot, and they're leaving things up to chance, and we never want to see that. For people to truly achieve their dreams, both short-term and long-term, we know the best solution is to have both insurance protection and investment growth in your plan. Protection and growth reinforce each other in a way that's been proven to result in higher financial outcomes than they could ever do alone. And I'm so proud that we've seen so many people plan in that way over the last year and then get those kind of outcomes. And then lastly, the last year has underscored one of the foundational beliefs of Northwestern Mutual, which is the importance of having a trusted advisor who's there with you through every step of your financial journey. You know, as a mutual company, our sole purpose is to serve our policy owners with complete dedication to doing what's in their best interest. And that's been our commitment for generations, and it's going to be our commitment for generations yet to come. We know that economies move up and down. Unexpected things happen, but we are here in good times and when there's volatility, building and maintaining financial strength. Because we want you to know that this company will have your back for generations to come. So with that, Kamilah and Brent, thank you very much. Thanks for your time today. And thank all of you in the audience for joining us today, but mostly for putting your trust in our company. please know you can reach out to us or our financial representatives at any time. Thanks.